If you work with people from many different cultures and different languages, you're going to love this video because we are going to be walking through how to easily set up your fill-out forms to allow for different languages. We're going to be able to translate the form. We're going to enable Google Translate. There's a lot of different options here that Fillout has made available, and we're going to walk through them all. So if you're looking to understand how to work better in multiple languages with your fill-out forms, stick around. And let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth, and this is Gap Consulting. It's my mission here to help you unlock the full potential of no-code tools and fill out forms. Those are one of the most vital tools that we use in almost all of our different solutions. Fillout is a very robust form software. If you haven't already started using it, you will absolutely love the ease of its interface and how beautifully it integrates with other no-code tools like Airtable for a back-end database, or maybe Softer for a front-end interface. So lots of options, but Fillout is where it's at for building your most robust tools. Now, before we get into the heart of this video, I first want to invite you to join me for a little Airtable crash course. Airtable is the most frequently used back-end database for Fillout, and taking our crash course is going to get you up to speed quickly in Airtable so that you're building better forms and collecting that data better and faster. So grab that crash course at gapconsulting.io/airtable-crash-course. But without further ado, let's hop on into my screen and we're going to walk through these different settings for Translate. So we're going to start actually with a template here. Follow along with me in your own Fillout account if you'd like. I'm going to say create here and I'm going to go down to form. And I'm going to create from a template. Again, I don't really care what the actual form is for our purpose. It's not so important. Let me go ahead and find an application form, and we'll go with a job application form template. And it looks just like this. This is the form itself, pretty straightforward. And then it looks like it's got a thank you page. So let's go ahead and use this template. We will install it in our selection here. And I'm just going to call this example so that I can delete it out later. So this is the new form. We've just named it, we've created it. Wherever you are in your form, again, assuming that you're working with other languages, this is how we get to the part where we start working with different translations. Now, to get kicked off on our translation, actually, it's a place we don't go to all that often when we're using Fillout. It is the settings on our form. So it's actually up in the upper right corner, right next to the preview button. So we're gonna select the settings here, and it's gonna pop this up. And if we go down to language on the left-hand side, you're gonna see the different options for us. Now, Fillout has already enabled many different languages, and you can see them right here. Right here, we're setting the default language. So what is this setting? The default language is the default language of the form for labels. So for example, those commonly used things like the word other. Let's imagine that you had a checkbox where you had other, where they could select from, you know, option 1, 2, or 3, and then you had an other where they could write in. Well, that common language can be automatically translated, and that's what you're getting with that default language right here. So this is saying in other messages, you know, similar idea there. So it does not adjust, though, this is important, it does not adjust the question labels. So again, let's flip back to our form really quickly and take a look. The first question here, what is your full name? That is not going to change. We, if we want to translate this or change the way that this shows up, we can change the way that the field shows up right here. But in terms of translations, when we go down to language again, let's go ahead and change this to, let's say, French. So you'll notice again, dozens of different languages available here, listed out in alphabetical order. I'm going to select French if I can find it from the list here. Not in alphabetical order for some reason. It's seeming to be out of order there, but I'm going to choose this one. And we have to publish the form to see those changes take effect. So let's go ahead and back out here. And you'll notice that only certain things have actually changed here. So where we used to have city or town, it now says ville. And where it's used to be the state, it's now saying, I don't know my French that well. I think this said région, which I can't seem to get. Ah, there we go. It's back there. So these parts have been changed mostly because this is an address a field type. So again, those common parts within the form, the parts that like code postal, This right here is being translated because that component of the form is easily translated to whatever language. But the specific forms that, or the specific fields that we created in the form, like what is your availability, that's not where we had to change. Now, on the same token though, let's look at the other option, because we mentioned this as being one of those components that might, or that will be included with the translate. If we add the other option, we have now the French word for other showing up here, and not the, the English word, right? If we go back, of course, and we go back to language and we put this back to an English form, let me find English from the list here. Here we go. And go back to the form. Again, now we're going to see the word other, right? We see state slash province. We see postal code, right? City. So you get the idea. Those components that are more programmable and less customized, right? These different components, like what is your availability? That's something that we have direct control over and we can change. But that's only one of the translate options here. So let's go back into our settings and explore some other stuff. Again, heading back into language. So that's the default language. Next is enabling translations. So when we toggle this on, we can allow viewers or users to view the form in different languages. So look at this, make your form accessible to users in different languages. We can now add it. So let's go ahead and pop in the French again. So we'll go ahead and create this. So we have the French version of the form being translated right now. And again, the default language is now set to English. So imagine now that we worked in both of these languages. Let's say we did visas between the US and Canada, for example. That might be a reason for this. We could go ahead and with this form, actually see the translation when we access it. Now from here, I'm going to publish those changes, right? And we're going to look at the actual form itself. Let's go ahead and preview it. And you'll notice now that we have this little option up here in the upper right corner that allows us to switch between the different languages. But again, what we need to point out is that in this case, the entire form has been translated. So you noticed how there was a bit of a processing time when we added the French version of the form. This is my preferred approach here. I like to set my default mode because again, we have direct control over the default language and exactly how the different questions will show up. And then all we have to do is if we want to enable additional languages, as we've done here, you know, now we have, you know, this is saying, you know, what's your full name? Quel est votre nom complet? And this was automatically translated. You did not see me go in there and do this myself. So this is a way that we can make our form accessible to multiple users of different cultures, different languages, and allow them to interact with that data. It's the same form. They're still filling out the same field with the same information, but it's making it accessible to them in the language that they're most comfortable with. So this is just absolutely game-changing for anybody doing business, again, over multiple languages. Now let's go ahead and exit the preview, and I want to show you one final key here, and that is in the settings on the language component. We can also opt to disable the auto-translate, right? We can also go right to left. I should point out this is, there are two additional things that we can look at. So if the language, you know, reads right to left, make sure to toggle this on. That's pretty self-explanatory. But disabling the auto-translate is something you might want to consider because many people access their languages through their Google browser now. I know for me, when I'm working in a different language, if the website is, you know, built in a certain language, I will, that's not English, it's easiest for me to read English, so I like to translate it back. And so this is a browser setting that many people have enabled. You might opt to disable that if you want to make sure that they use your translated version. Because if you keep this toggled on, you can get, you know, things can get a little confusing, right? Google browser or the browser might try to translate using Google Translate, and then you might then have your translate version as well, and the wires might get crossed. So if you are enabling specific languages to be translated from your form, you might also opt to disable the auto-translate. And that way, people visiting your form will be directed right to the language button to make a change here, as opposed to using the translate in their browser and then confusing matters. So all in, pretty simple options here, easy to access. As you saw, we turned the entire form into French with just a few clicks, and we allow people now to toggle between the two. If you want to change the core of your questions, of course, set your default language from the beginning of the form creation and then set up your questions as is appropriate for that language. So as you see though, some really simple settings, simple to implement, can have really profound impact on accessibility to your form across multiple languages. I hope you got a ton of value from this video. And if you are working in multiple languages, take a look at Fill Out Forms, specifically the language and translate options. That's it for this one. If you did enjoy the video, we'd love a thumbs up and of course, subscribe to the channel if you like this content. Swing by our website if you have any questions that are a little bit more advanced that we did not answer here. But of course, most importantly, keep on building.